They certainly are, Tom. Joan Perkins has been bringing her gorgeous Belgian draft horses to community events for 20 years. They weigh about 2,000 pounds apiece, and when they spooked, Joan made the decision to put her body between those horses and the dozens of people attending the festival. It was a courageous act that spared innocent people but left Joan trampled by her horses and the carriage. Tonight she's fighting for her life inside a Boston hospital.
Less than a minute into the ride, all of a sudden we heard snap.
Kim Walters was on the carriage that she thinks malfunctioned. The driver tried to calm the Belgians with voice commands, but things only got worse.
And when he did that, the carriage slammed into the horses, causing the horses to spook.
Investigators say the timing couldn't have been worse. When something spooked that first team of horses, a second team was approaching, and that created a domino effect.
It looked like both horses hit both horses. It looked like the both sets of horses went into each other and then went off to the left.
In the middle of the chaos, Joan Perkins, who owns and raises these beauties at this Epping farm, took a huge risk to try to keep everyone else safe.
Lloyd got thrown off his carriage, and the wife ran in front of the horses to try to stop them, got ran over by the horses, and then by the carriage.
She, certainly put herself well in harm's way in order to sort of bring the situation under control, and in many ways could certainly be considered a hero for doing that.
Todd Wagner is the third of four generations to operate Apple Crest. Sunday's accident is the first of its kind here. Now the sight of state troopers interrupts the picturesque farm that is at the height of the harvest and school tours and sales. The work continues, but thoughts and prayers are going out to 51-year-old Joan Perkins, as well as her good friend Greg Dow. He was driving the carriage that had the problem and is recovering from head and leg injuries at home. Four riders suffered injuries as well, but Kim says this freak accident won't keep her from hayrides or Apple Crest.
I'd go back there in a heartbeat. I would.
Still not clear what exactly happened with the carriage that spooked the horses. In fact, OSHA now trying to determine whether they have jurisdiction in this case so they can investigate. The Wagner family says they will offer horse-drawn hay rides next weekend. Live in the newsroom, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.